the unmatched heroism of the 1st Infantry Division, Allied forces were able to overpower Axis troops at Jela and Troina. Even the tanks of the mighty Hermann Goering Division were no match for one of the most accomplished American fighting units of World War II. In 37 days of continuous fighting, the Big Red One had taken control of 18 towns and villages. Operation Husky was an unmitigated Allied success as Axis forces were driven from the island and the Mediterranean sea lanes reopened. Italian dictator Benito Mussolini is removed from power and Italy surrenders on September 8, 1943. Churchill and Roosevelt, believing that momentum had shifted to the Allies' side, commit to opening a second front in Europe to aid the besieged Russian army. Involving over 4,000 landing craft and preceded by U.S. and British airborne drops, Operation Overlord is to be the largest amphibious invasion in history. Now under the command of Major General Clarence R. Huebner, the division sails back to the British Isles that October and begins training for what would become one of the most decisive conflicts of the war. In the early morning hours of June 6, 1944, under the umbrella of the English Channel's unpredictable weather, the invasion gets underway. The 1st Infantry Division is tasked with securing a section of the Normandy coast designated as Omaha Beach. But the German army is well prepared, and Rommel himself, looking for retribution for his sound defeat in North Africa, is tasked with the defense of northern France. The definitive turning point in the war is at hand, and Hitler's Fortress Europa will soon taste the full fury of the battle-hardened troops of the Big Red One.
Those Navy guys do this.
This is gonna be no sweat, right, guys? I mean, they probably don't even know we're coming. Just like the lieutenant said.
Oh, yeah, sure. Just like the lieutenant said.
Hey, Sarge! Why aren't we in those Higgins boats with the rest of the division?
Because it's our job to make sure those boys get to the beach alive, Private Kelly. I can't believe we're not getting any fire from the beach. Maybe our boys did a better job than we thought. On your feet, Corporal. radio tower! We gotta take it out! Find those damn mortar pits and take them out! Suppress that machine gun! Bandage and brass, boys. There's a supply depot beyond these doors we still need to secure.
Do we have any idea how well guarded this thing is, Sarge?
No idea, Kelly, but Fox's orders are to secure that depot, whatever the resistance.
Same drill as always, eh, Sarge?
Now someone get those goddamn doors open! One more to go!
Drums! Move up! Reload!
Gentlemen! Just a quick word. I've scraped through some tough fights since I've been in this man's army. I have to say that this one was the worst I've seen. We lost a lot of good men back there on that beach, and that's a damn shame. But by kicking down Hitler's front door, we saved the lives of hundreds more that will follow. You are the best of the best, and I am damn proud to serve with each and every one of you. All right, enough said. Gather up some ammo, get some rest. I have a feeling that we're just getting started.